about how to draw shear force diagram and moment diagram in MATLAB. So let's go. This is our beam. Here is 500 moment, and there is fixed load, and there is uniformly distributed load. The beam is total 6 meter, and we have to draw SFD and BMD for this. This is the program. So I run it, and here is this all of the moment and other thing, and there is the moment diagram. Here is the moment diagram. You see here moment, slope, and deflection. So let's go about how can I program in this. So first I talk about how to read the image. This is the image is SFD BMD. So I type exact name in there, SFD BMD, and size is 0.5, or you can change it 0.6 or something. And I take length 6 meter according to the thing here, 6 meter length. This is the UDL, and this is F node fixed load. This is M node is here, moment diagram, and this is elastic modulus I given in here, and this is the inertia. So first I have to take the R1, that is reaction at node A, so with respect to point C. So I take this, and this is the equation. And similarly, I take the R2 as my calculation, and I set up X as a line space. That means X may be in there anywhere. There will be X like that. X equals to 2, X equals to 3, X equals to 4, X equals to 5. So line space means I set up X 0 to 1, 0, 1. That means it will go 100 units. Each unit I take dx, that means l by 100. That means I divide this length totally 100 times. So if you want to take more than, so change in here like that. If you take 500, so 501, and change in here 5, that means you divide all the beam into 5 dx small unit, dx small unit. And I take 100, so I take there, and then I moment. The moment is critical thing. So there is M1, there is M2, and the M1 I take it from this portion with R1. So R1 multiplied this distance. So this distance is you see here the total distance is 6 meter. So this is half. That means X is here 50 and X is here 25, right? So here from 1 to 26, MATLAB read one unit more than the defined unit. So it take 1 to 26 X, and M2 it takes here 27 to 51, and from here it takes 52 to 101 unit. So I define this X and R another thing, and this is M1, and the left side, right side is M2, and with this with corresponding this is M3. And I will form a vector of M1, M2, M3 in here. And the theta is cumulative trapezoid. So what is cumulative trapezoid? The cumulative trapezoid, let's take a half. So cumulative trapezoid is the integration. For example, if you want to take here cumulative trapezoid, so here trapezoid is a vector containing the numerical integration of y. So it is the integration. So we know one thing, that if you want to take slope, from moment, you have to integrate this moment. You will find slope. Again, if you want to make deflection, you have to integrate slope so that you can find the deflection. So for deflection integration, it's a cumulative trapezoid. That means we divide this beam 100 times. So each time, each one is like that, a trapezoid shape. And its theta is divided by multiplied dx ei. Similarly, the deflection is the cumulative this one multiplied dx. And this is the boundary condition. So boundary condition is like that. When there is deflection here, x equals to when there is length is zero, so deflection and this deflection is b1, and when there is length equals l, the deflection gives you 101. That means this one, and this is the boundary condition. And you remember that the boundary condition defined by this thing. This is not divide thing. Divide, that means this one, and this is the boundary condition defined. And here the theta, that means the theta will increase. How can it will be increase? According to the boundary condition, it will go there. So, and again the deflection, it also increase with this thing. And again for plotting of SFD and BMD, so subplot 3 1 1, that means you divide all of the graph into three rows. So first rows it will plot moment here. M means moment, and grid, you on the grid, this is green. And in the second plot it will plot theta, so that means slope, and grid is on. And in the third slope it will plot deflection, and here is the deflection. And here again there is some positioning 300 400 like that, this one 500, this one. And one more thing here, if you want to find like that, if you want to find here x equals 4, like that x equals 4 in here, so or 5 or 3 and something in here, you want to find moment. So if you put the x equals to 4, then it will give the moment value, slope value, and deflection value. So let's type it in here like that, x equals 5. So run it. You see here the desired moment is x equals 203. The desired is 0.0016. Let's go there, 0.0013, like that in here or something. So this is the way you can solve the MATLAB. So if you like my video, please subscribe my channel. And in the next video I will discuss different tools how can you solve like that from here. So this is my website, and from this website here I will discuss some of the tools that you can solve in the online, like that you can solve in the online in the next video. So thanks for watching my video.